just making memories of us.
Ryan Moberly, and you know me as Ryan here on YouTube, and this is going to be my entry for Arfalc77's Making Memories contest. And I tell you, this is a really interesting idea, and I'm really excited about this contest. Michael, he's a great guy here on YouTube, really optimistic, and he makes great and funny videos. Actually, he has some family members here on YouTube. He is under the username Arfalc77, and his brother, the King, K-16. He's K-16 on here, and Bob, if you're watching this, I still, to this day, I have that package you sent me a long time ago with that King's treasure chest, and that was really cool. From video, also his son is on here too, under the name Mini Boog. So anyway, I actually entered Michael's contest, oh, it was a year ago, and actually I won it all, and that was really exciting to win it all. So I'm going to try my best to win this contest, and for this contest, he wants us to answer some questions involving memories. Alright, so question one. I do too many videos in this room. I gotta venture out somewhere else. Come on, guys, let's take a walk. This is O'Connor Calling Park, named in the honor of two Blue Angel pilots who died tragically in a plane crash. For those of you that don't know, the Blues actually got their start in my hometown of Pensacola. The base they're stationed at is actually about a minute away from my house, 2 minutes at least from my house or so. And the reason I came here is because there's a lot of memories in this place, being the local neighborhood park and whatnot. Ah, that's much better. You know, really beautiful weather here in Florida at this time. Alright, so the first question Michael asks is, what's your favorite sports memory? And for me, that has to go back to the year 2009. I believe it was 2009. Well, my dad got us a one-year subscription to XM Satellite Radio, and he hooked it up in my room because I had two nice speakers in there at the time. And our main purpose was getting that is we were going to listen to WGN Radio and listen to some Cubs games because we're real big Cubs fans. And a memory I got out of that, listening to those Cubs games, was this: listening to Ron Santo, who was the commentator on WGN Radio at the time. And you know, he's a Cubs legend, used to play for the Cubs, actually just got in the Hall of Fame, which is really cool. And you know, he just loved the Cubs, he loved baseball, he loved what he did. And you know, whenever there was like a great, the Cubs made a great play, he'd be like, you know, oh yes.
The 3-2 from Zambrano. Swing on this!
Yes!
No-hitter! A no-hitter!
Unbelievable, Patrick. How great is this, huh? How great is this?
And then, you know, whenever they made a bad play, he'd be like, you know, oh no, the complete opposite. And, you know, he really got into the games. Really funny, really cool commentator. And it's a shame he's no longer with us. He passed away. He had a lot of trouble, and you knew it wasn't looking good for him, but you hoped that he would, you know, continue to stay alive and whatnot. Really a shame that he's no longer with us. We actually purchased right before he died, actually, an 8x10 signed photo of him, and we got that framed and hanging in the living room now. So it's a real shame that Ron is no longer with us, and I know a lot of Cubs fans, you know, have that same feeling, because he was a great guy. Alright, moving on to question two. This is an interesting one. What's your favorite YouTube memory? And I tell you, when I think about that, it's gotta be the Subscriber Bowl 2000 that Arfalc, Michael held about a year ago. And it was basically this tournament, March Madness tournament style video contest. And he had to make a video related to sports cards or YouTube or whatever. And I made this first video called Addicted. And a lot of people liked it. It got a lot of comments, a lot of thumbs up. And that moved me on, got me into the actual tournament. And then, you know, each week I made a video and I advanced on every week in the tournament. And I ended up winning it all. And that was just really cool because, you know, a lot of my family helped me make the video. So that was cool to work with them on my videos. And then I got a lot of attention here on YouTube. And I owe that all to Michael. You know, I got to talk to a lot of people. A lot of people messaged me saying they like my videos. And that was really cool to have my 15 minutes of fame, so to speak, here on YouTube. So then I owe that all to Michael. Now, speaking of Michael, question three. What's the first Arfalc77 video that you watched? And that's an interesting one. don't know for sure. I actually went back on his channel not too long ago to discover what was the first video I watched. And I owe it all to Manny, All-Star Jersey Shop here on YouTube. He led me to Michael because he made a video one time just praising Michael, saying that he's the reason that he's on YouTube and he makes some cool videos. So I knew I had to check this guy out. I don't remember the first, but the earliest one I remember watching was not a sports card video. It was called The $6 Million Man, starring Sevens. And basically, it was about him documenting a shoulder surgery that he got. And, you know, at the start of the video, he started out all groggy. He was like, hey, guys, this is Sevens.
What up, YouTube? This is Sevens. Gonna chronicle my surgery.
And then at the end of the video, you know, he was more upbeat. The medicine he was taking had worn off, and you know, he was really funny. He was like, you know, hey guys, I'm back.
It's all done. I can now look forward, getting this stuff healed up, being bionic again, and getting back to the stuff I like to do so much.
And one thing I remember in the video is he pulled out this vial just like halfway in the video. He's like, hey, here's the gunk they pulled out of my shoulder. And it's like, oh my God, don't show that. I'm not going to show you that, guys, that clip, because it was just disturbing. He pulls out, hey, here's what they just pulled out of my shoulder. And I was like, I don't like the medical stuff, the body and whatnot. I'm not good when watching that stuff. So that was kind of disgusting, Michael. And now moving on to question, what is this, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, question 4. What's your favorite Arfalc video? And I tell you, it's everyone's favorite. It's the anthem of male days here on YouTube. It's kind of a viral video here in the community. And that would have to be...
eBay dude, don't send me cards without a penny sleeve or a top loader.
And the reason I love it is because I love the Beatles. So when E started singing that opening riff, you know, eBay Dude, I was like, hey, that's Hey Jude, which is a great Beatles song, long 7-minute anthem. That the Beatles did great song. Excuse me, I'm losing my voice. And you know, a lot of people feel that pain. You know, I've never had a bad eBay experience, knock on wood. But you know, a lot of people have, and a lot of people are pissed because you know, you pay money for this card you want and it comes up, you know, ripped in half or something. That reminds me also, Michael had a video called Fix You, and he got this just torn up eBay card in the mail, and you know, he tried to like glue it back together. That was hilarious. But definitely favorite video, Michael, was eBay Dude. And I've seen that in a video before, and I know you commented on that, so that was pretty cool. Question 5 is a really serious question, and I'm going to give you guys a really good answer for this one. I actually have 2. Now, one of my answers involves sports. Now, I've talked about this a lot in my videos, and I'm going to show you my hat here. Next year, my city, Pensacola, we're going to be getting a double-A minor league baseball team, Southern League, called the Pensacola Blue Wahoos, and that's this hat I'm wearing here. It's a bat. A Blue Wahoo's a fish. And you know, you see the fish is swimming around the bat here, so it makes a P for Pensacola. And I'm really excited about this because it's going to open up a lot of things. Now, the first 3 games, unfortunately, are sold out. Not going to be able to go to those. But I hope to go to a lot with my family and friends, and that's going to create a lot of cool memories. And also, it's going to open up a lot of YouTube opportunities for me. I hope to go to, you know, find maybe the players' parking lot at the players' entrance or the locker room entrance before the game and get some in-person autographs. And you know, I know a lot of people are in that here on YouTube. They do the in-person signings and whatnot, so that's going to be cool. I'm hopefully going to meet a lot of people out of that. And also, Jim Riggleman, for you Cubs fans, he's going to be the manager, and he used to play for the Cubs. He actually used to be the Nationals manager, and I want to meet him. I want to get his signature on a nice Cubs photo. I really want to meet him, so hopefully I get the chance. Who knows? And that's definitely going to be a video, if I do, my meeting of Jim Riggleman, if that happens. Answer 2 to this question, a little more serious, involves my life itself. I'm a sophomore in high school, going to be a junior in like 3 months. I cannot believe it. Going to enter a time in my life where I have to make a lot of decisions. You know, where do I want to go to college? What do I want to do with my life? What do I want to major in? Where do I want to go? Do I want to start a family? Just a lot of serious questions. A new chapter in my life is going to begin soon. And you know, I have to decide, what am I going to do with my life? And you know, I can only hope that it goes the best. You know, I want a good life for me. I want to live a good life. I want to live a fun life. I just want to have a great life. And I can only hope, you know, that the best happens. You know, stuff happens to people. And I just want to go to college. I want to get a good education. I want to have a fun job. Maybe start a family, go to a new town, explore, travel. I just want to have a positive, optimistic life. I hate my camera sometimes. It cuts out during the best parts of my video. Anyway, sorry about that, guys. As I was saying, I just want to live an optimistic, positive life. And that's all I can ask for. And that'll about wrap it up for me. That'll do it. And thanks to Michael, Arfalc77's, so much for this contest. Really had fun thinking about answers and whatnot. And that's going to do it for me, guys. All right, thanks for watching. See ya. Every mile, memory. Every song, another scene. From some old movie, going back in time to you and me. Every day, if heads turn down. Every night, a lonesome sound. Like the freight train rolling through my dreams. Every mile, a memory.
Red sundown, out across the western sky, takes me back to the fire in your eyes. Texas stars in a purple night, not seeing them with you, baby. Oh, they never do look right, no. Every mile, a memory. Every song, another scene. From some old movie, going back in time to you and me. Every day, a page turned down. Every night, a lonesome sound. Like a freight train rolling through my dreams. Every mile, a memory. Every mile a memory, every song another scene, from some old movie going back in time. Every day a page turns.